Hey, how is everyone? Welcome back to another episode of Hexa Gear Review. Today we are going to take a look at the Hexa Gear Governor X Armor Type Quetzal by Kotobukiya. If you're wondering where I got these Hexa Gear kits, be sure to check out hobbyfrontline.com and use the coupon code JETOHOBBY5OFF to get 5% off on all your purchase. Terms and conditions apply. I will leave the details in the description for you to check it out. Now here we go. So for a bit of background for this model kit here, the X Armor Type Quetzal was released in July 2019, so it is a relatively new kit, but does it hold up all the good stuff we have seen before? Let's find out. First up, the box here is almost twice the size of what we have seen before. Out of the box, we have this longer than usual double-sided assembly manual, an entirely new set of 11 runners in total plus 5 pairs of hands and some pre-painted parts, and this little hexagram, and as usual, an incredible artwork. Moving on to the assembly, this kit comes with 93 parts in total. Besides the hands, there are no PVC parts at all. Almost everything is made out of ABS, which is good for nice and tight joints. But when assembling the main joints like arms and legs, you need a little bit of extra force. There is a tiny part that goes around the torso area, where you have to be extra careful because of how fragile it feels, which I will show later on in the video. There are some obvious knot marks here and there, which I will show you later as well. Besides that, it was really fun putting everything together. So that is how it looks snapped together without any glue and everything that it comes with. So there are 4 extra pairs of hands, a bow with the arrow and a set of arrows, a crossbow with the arrow and another set of arrows. Then there are these capes that they call security blanket. It comes in 2 styles for different poses, and a little pointy bits that can replace the big ponytail. It comes in 2 in case you accidentally lose one, and a bunch of adapters and connectors. The hexagram is already in there because we need to put the expansion unit here in order to use the blue capes. Let's quickly go over everything here. As for the main body, it looks really awesome in my opinion, and the color accuracy is not too bad. It is pretty much on point. Only the little details need a bit of painting, like the lining on the shoes, the armor edge and the side of the belt, the yellow sections on the abs and the root of the ponytail. There are some obvious knot marks behind the kneecaps and some on the back of the thigh. As I mentioned before, there is a fragile bit where you have to be careful when assembling it. This is a really thin piece of plastic that goes all the way across the chest. This part also caused another problem for us, which we will see later on. Now let's look at the accessories that it comes with. And as usual, all the weapons that it comes with are single color. With a bit of painting, you can get really beautiful bows and arrows. Let's start with the bow. There are 2 huge knot marks on the top and bottom limbs. I tried to clean it up just a little bit so you can still see it here. You have a stabilizer made of different color, and 2 hard points here which are 2mm holes, which I believe are what these connectors are for. These ones here, I believe, is for this set of arrows. The arrows have 3mm pegs on one side and the other is a 2mm hole. So you can put it on the bow here and here. With the 3mm peg, you can store it at the back like this, or the side of the leg like this. Or you can use these 2mm to 3mm connectors here to connect the bow on any 3mm hole that you can find, which I am not going to do because it might get stuck in there forever. If you want to store just the bow itself, you can use this type of adapter and put it on like this. To use the bow, you have a pair of dedicated hands. This is for holding the bow like so, and this is for pulling the arrow. No, we don't get the opposite pair of hands, so the bow can only be used right-handed. Next up, we have the crossbow. Once again, this needs to be painted for it to look better, and I have to say this crossbow is really fragile. You might need to glue these 2 pieces together because it falls out very easily. There's this set of bolts that can go to the bottom of the crossbow. It uses 3mm pegs, so you can put it anywhere you want. To use the crossbow, you will need dedicated hands as well. These 2 hands are slightly different. The one with more angle is to be used with the crossbow. The hands for the crossbow comes in a pair, so you can use it on whichever hand you like. To store the crossbow, you will need to use the same adapter as the bow, so you cannot store both of these on the backpack. Next, we have the capes. This here is for normal standing position, and this one here is for dynamic poses. Too bad they did not include another set of these, so when you change out the capes, you have to pluck these out as well. As you might have noticed, these capes are only meant to go on the left side of this figure. Then there are these little pointy bits that replaces the ponytail. As for the rest of the hands, you get a pair of closed fist hands, normal weapon holding hands, and an expressive open hand. Moving on to the articulation, I'm going to take these capes off as they get in the way. First, the ponytail is on the ball joint so it can go all the way around, and I'm going to take the ponytail off as it gets in the way as well. The head itself is also on the ball joint, so that's all the way up, all the way down, which is quite a bit. Tilting left, tilting right. This neck joint is actually quite tight, turning left and turning right. It is blocked by the collar here. As for the shoulders, there is a hinge joint at an angle, so you can bring it back and forth quite a bit, but you don't get any up and down for this one. There's a ball joint inside, but it is quite limited. That is all the way up, not even 90 degrees. Unless you want to flip the ball joint around, which is very bad for a Hexa-gear unit. What makes it worse is that the arms cannot fold any closer to the body than this, because that strap is in the way. This is a bad design. The upper arm, we have a pivot joint so we can turn it all the way around. As for the elbow, only a little bit over 90 degrees. All the given hands are just a ball joint, basically what we have seen before. Some of them are loose and some of them are just nice. So not very consistent when it comes to PVC hands. Next up, the torso is a ball joint where you can tilt all the way up, all the way down, side to side, all the way left and all the way right. There is no joint in the waist this time. Then the legs all the way up, blocked by the belt and the leg armor there, all the way to the side and all the way back. It has to be at an angle if you want to raise it up this high. The knee here is not bad, but we have seen better. Then the ankle, that's all the way up, all the way down. A pivot joint inside for side to side, and no, we don't get any left and right rotation this time. So from what we have seen before, this is the worst Hexa-gear we have seen so far in terms of articulation. In terms of size, here comes my standard size comparison, standing next to the real great Axia, a master great Dynamis. Here are some Pokeballs and his best friend, and finally here's a ruler. The Quetzal by default is slightly taller than the other Hexa-gear units. With the ponytail, he is about 89mm tall. So this kit here is not the best among the Hexa-gear line in terms of articulation. The arms and legs are quite limited this time, especially the arms. You can see that he failed to keep up with the stretching routine, but the joints are nice and tight. You will need a lot of patience when posing this with the bow, especially with the cape on. The hand for holding on the bow is going to fall on you a lot as you fiddle with it, because this kit overall is just not flexible enough. So how would I rate this kit? First, this is a killer right here. I absolutely love the overall look of it, but that's about it. The arm is just not flexible enough. Wearing the blue cape limits the range of movement even more. You may also find that you need some effort to balance this guy because of the added weight of the cape and the crossbow if you plan to have it on him. Also, you might want to add a bit of glue there for the crossbow, but overall, the tightness for the rest of the joints are quite nice. So this is only a 7 out of 10 for me. Now as for recommendation, buy this kit only if you are a Hexa-gear fan and you wanted to add this to your collection, and because you adore the look of this kit, and that's about it. Stay away if you want a model kit with decent articulation and if you don't think it's worth the price. As for the difficulty of assembling this kit, there are tiny parts in this kit and some parts feel quite fragile. You will need a bit more effort to get rid of all the nut marks. So it is more suitable for someone with some experience in model kits before. Beginners might need to be more careful with this. Alright guys, I have all the links in the description. Feel free to check out my other Hexa-gear reviews in my channel. And if you are buying from hobbyfrontline.com, don't forget to use a coupon code JEDOHOBBY5OFF to get 5% off on your next purchase. If you would like to know more about this model kit, let me know in the comment. And as always, I would really appreciate if you guys would give me a like, hit the subscribe button, and stay tuned for more JEDOHOBBY videos. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in the next one.